Hello everyone, Morten here, welcome to my review of New Game episode 20, the final episode, right? My episode later on, so on. I find that's a really good episode. It wasn't very comedic, of course. It had like pretty much no comedy. It had a few good jokes in there, like the pants and stuff and so on, right? But mainly, of all the animes they see so far, this actually felt like the most ending of any endings. Like, yeah, like, oh, more than I watched this season has been like last week and this week, has been like, right, then, not my ending. This actually felt like a really ending, even though it's a comedic anime. This felt like, yeah, this is an actual end here. It's like, the main character's goal, right, is to beat this person. And it kind of is like she won there, because she's leaving on her own, like, well, I saw you, I started feeling content. Yeah, like, I was starting before you got here. So I have to leave now to improve myself and so on. And of course, that's been building up in early episodes as well, right? So I think that was really good, actually. And her leaving is a huge change, of course, to the episode, or better to the anime, how it's set up, right? Because Aoba is the character with the most screen time. Then it was Yagami Ko. Then I would say it's Neneshi, after she gets introduced in episode like 6 or 7, episode 1. So without Yagami in it, it's going to be a big difference there. So that's like a huge stepping stone, actually, for the anime. I like it a lot in that sense. Then the episode wasn't super high paced, though. There's a lot of, like, crying and hugging. A lot of crying and hugging. Of course, the problem with the anime is that it's very much, like, cute girls or cute stuff. And it's very, very much played on a lot of Yuri stuff, right? A lot of, like, girl-on-girl tendencies. It's like, obviously, Tomoya is in love with Yagami. Just doesn't really say it. And it's a lot, like, she's in love with her, like, over your best friends. More like, oh, I can't live without you. Please don't leave me for another man. Or, like, yeah, it's like, well, wait, more of that, right? So, of course, it's a little infuriating in the anime that this keeps on the same level as they do. Because when you see the scene here where she's, like, crying on her back, and then Rin almost falls over, right? And Yagami grabs her hands, puts her into herself, and they stare at each other there. And it's, like, it's very, very classic, like, kissing scene, right? And they don't kiss like that. It's a little frustrating, though, right? You almost feel that you kissed it, right? I mean, it's kind of obvious. And that's a little poor here in this kind of anime, that they use, like, oh, we're very, very much playing on, like, the lesbian, the Yuri. Yeah, we're very much playing on that. And it's very, they're more than friends, but they're never going to show it, even though they kind of sleep together. In episode. Yeah, almost, yeah. Like, it's almost like they almost kind of do it, but they don't do it, right? So the episode, it's, of course, really irritating, in one sense, because it's like, okay, here it's clear it should be a kiss here. It's like a typical, don't leave me, or like, I quit my job here and follow you to friends. Don't gonna contradict about me, or like, you know, don't you love me enough to stay? So yeah, like, it's clearly that kind of, like the kind of scene, right? And it's just like, oh, I love you, but I have to evolve. Yeah, and it's kind of like that, and you feel that she really should kiss your ear and say, I love you, but I have to go for this job. You can if you want to come with me, we can live together in France or something like that. Let's elope together, yeah, kind of like what. And it's just like, but they can't really push that limit in that, because they refuse to take the step over, right? The classic, like, almost kissing each other a few times, and they do even the same thing even later on again, right, with Yagami and Aoba as well. But especially say that scene with Rin and Yagami is like, oh man, if it was like a man and a woman here, they clearly would have kissed in this scene. Like, this is a clear setup for a kissing scene. And you can't do it, right? So that's a little, like, that is frustrating. But anyway, like, the Aoba scene, Aoba and Yagami, so there she was kind of set off, so that was over there, when she took up her scene, right? So that was actually kind of early in the episode, which surprised me, because when she took up her new scene there, that was like in 4 minutes or so, that kind of surprised me, because it's so early, showing that, okay, she's gonna leave now, because that is probably very, very, you know, against you, whatever policies, rules, so you have for the company, right? It's like you brought up someone else that we told specifically could not be named on this game, or she could be named, of course, as a lead artist or whatever, but you couldn't have her as like the art director or whatever title is specifically. So yeah, we refuse to have that because it would cost us money, right, on the sales, and how you are in press release, and it's like the week before thing, and you brought it up anyway. Yeah, like they would absolutely probably, maybe not fire her because it's just a big name, but they would be like, yeah, this is going to piss people off, right? So when she did that, very early episode, I was like, okay, she's going to leave now, because that's like, okay, in two reasons, right? Obviously, purely like canon story-wise, that would, as I said, that would make your be really sitting in a loose end there at the job, right? But also, of course, she's taking up Aoba saying, okay, I know you all love me here in Japan, but I'm going away. So, yeah, screw you guys. That was like, I'm going away, I'm gonna leave this thing, I'm gonna work on complete other stuff. So you see this girl here, this little girl here called Aoba, she's the new Mia. She's a rising star in next fairy story, 4-4, believe in this woman, okay, I'm out there. It almost is kind of like, you know, giving her the torch, yeah, leaving there. So I think it was a very good scene. And I think, yeah, it was a very good scene. I'm surprised with one thing, then, as I mentioned, that it was so early. Because obviously, during that scene, it's like, okay, she's gonna leave now. So, yeah, it's very, very much like, okay, she is gonna leave. It's like that, yeah. You have to watch the episode to understand how it's gonna end, right? Because, like, there's no way they can go back from this scene. So I always expected it to be a little later. But instead, it went by the kind of romantic love, like, best friend slash mentor and disciple or... Yeah, like back and forth. They kind of mixed it all together, right, with Yagami and Aoba. They're both like, we both are rivals in a way. I'm also teaching you to hate me, and I love you, and you love me. And they're going back and forth all that, right? So, and for that ending instead, it was pretty good, though. So I'm saying it's bad. I'm saying that as a cliffhanger, like, okay, so you're going to leave or not? That was good very, very early. And then, of course, more of the jokes. There were very few jokes in the episode, though. Which, that's probably only, I say, our big lack of the episode. There probably could have been more jokes, right? I liked when, like, and then you see, now you see, it's like, Rumiko-san, don't leave us too! It's like, that was good. She's like, maybe I should go there. And then Christina's like, drunk, like, I can't fix it! It's gonna cause this! And then, and Haruka is like, no, you're ruining my company! No, take all of my girls! No! My paradise! So that's good. And of course, like, lovebirds, not that thing. She's like, oh, like, get a room, you two, yeah? Like, she's like, let's leave them alone. Let them go and do what they want. You know, yeah, like, stop disturbing their love and so on. So there are a lot of jokes there. Obviously, the best joke episode was the pantsuit scene. It really was. I like the scene. It's very subtle, very nice scene there. It was like, what was Yagami like? She's like, let me see this best film. The mind bubble already over. It's like, pants. She's like, I can't tell her that. It's like, I can't tell her that. It's like, come on, tell me. I saw her naked the first day. Only pantsu? I was like, what? Only pantsu? But yep. Only pantsu. That's my argument. He's like, I can see it happening. And anyway, that scene was great, though. The Momo scene, when she's left, she's flying to France, right? And then now she's like, do you actually get employed? Like, did you get your, like, the paperwork or, like, has she reviewed you of your art? It's like, Yagami never reviewed my art. And then, of course, Rin is like, oh, she did. I think it should be all fine. It's like, I hope. It's like, damn it, Yagami. Baka. Yeah, that's a classic scene there. Like, horrible boss. That was probably the best part. I thought it was dialogue being with her and the old boss, like, you're selfish. I'm a selfish. I'm sorry. Like, yeah, you're so selfish. How can you just leave us? Well, I'm selfish. That's why I can't leave you guys. It's like, how can you do this to us? But you just confirmed that she is very, very much thinking all about herself. She's like, yeah, that is the cute Yagami core for sure, right? So the last stretch I'm talking about again is, of course, Momo and Aoba. What's kind of cute there, when she's like, Aoba, I can see it on you. And also because Momo is also kind of weird, not very social, adept character. She's like, come with me, you follow me now. Yeah, I was like, this is a little weird, forcing her to go there. And of course, she's like, the food. How is she going to eat in there? No, but generally, I think it was pretty good how they developed the relationship. So they were more friendly terms. So, of course, earlier saw that, or find out by Hifumi, which is a good scene, by the way. Next Hifumi, texting Hifumi, 1 meter from her, it's like, Hifumi senpai. That's a good scene. She knows Hifumi's personality, yeah, I have to text her. Finding out that they all have already tasted defeat. And only the good chooks moment was like, she's already adept at taking the sting of defeat. It's so unfair. It's like, yeah, she's a lead on me, knowing that she needs to be beaten. So that's kind of like, that's a weird way of saying it. But okay, fine. She gets that, and they get to on the train together, right, talk a little bit. And of course, it ends with them being like, I'm going to beat you. Don't you worry, I'm still your enemy. Kind of, right? Yeah, so but I love it, because she can't admit it. It's like, I'm gonna beat you. Kind of say, as with Umiko as well, there, being kind of Yagami's foil, right? She entered like, don't eat bad food or like, travel food. Yeah, I don't like you. I'm saying that. So that's good. But generally, much more, of course, a dramatic love episode, romantic episode. than any comedy. It had a few good scenes. That being said, though, the comedy in it, because it's always a comedy anime, the comedy in it, and the few scenes that were there, as I was talking about now, they were all really good scenes, though. So, like, they had that going for it, right? Like, every comedic scene was really good, but it had a very few of them. So, overall, I think it was a good episode. As I said earlier, I liked that it definitely felt like an ending. Like, it ended the whole, like, Aoba trying to beat Yagami, it ended the whole season 2's general plotline, right? And also, of course, it ended the game production. The Peck game is finished, so next season then, hopefully this season then they're gonna make a new game, and if it is season 3, right, they're gonna make Fair Stories or something else, right? So that's something else. Probably gonna come out Uva, where they do something cute in between there. And that's why I say on the last note, though, so I said, I mean, I get you left and everything, it's fine that, but I do see some other characters going down this bit, right, because the Uva, there's no way the Uva is gonna feature, like, Rin tomorrow. Maybe calling Yagami every day Japan, or from Japan, right, maybe. Otherwise, kind of like, she's kind of obsolete because she's only in relation to Yagami Koa. Umiko still has a relation with Nenechi and somewhat Naruchi, but mainly Nenechi. But she had like half her scene with Nenechi, half with Yagami. So it's also kind of like, yeah, so there's more Nenechi time, I guess. But they kind of went for that in the end anyway, just having a lot of Nenechi. Nenechi working there, fighting with Naruchi and so on. So I guess that. That could work if you're even more focused on energy, which was the best character, so why not? So yeah, but there can be some problems there that Yagami is going out there, because like the older character, right, they kind of have the most connection with her, also with Haruka as well, but yeah, mainly, of course, Rinden. They're all like, they have less scenes, I would guess, in the tree. So in the OVA, I'm just going to throw one in the OVA, it's gonna be like Nenechi Aoba probably, and maybe some other characters, but mainly focus on them, right? For sure. So anyway, see you guys. Hope you liked the review. I might do a bigger review of all the episodes, maybe if I have time. I don't think about it. We haven't been a good season of New Game as the first season. So anyway, have a great day, and I'll see you guys.